How would that make you feel, 4 more years of Donald Trump?
To be honest, we're all bracing ourselves, but we've already heard some rumors that what the administration has in store for us in terms of immigration policy is all the much worse coming up. For example, we've heard reports that it's the intention of Stephen Miller, who is the president's top advisor when it comes to drafting immigration policy, that he intends to attempt to get rid of birthright citizenship in the United States, which is something that has been with us since the end of the Civil War in the 1800s and is encapsulated in the Constitution in one of the amendments. We're also hearing that the intention is to get rid of our refugee numbers down to zero so that, in essence, we would be reneging on our obligations under international law and not accepting any refugees for resettlement in the United States. So we, as advocates, we've had a trying 4 years, but we are concerned, but we're a very determined group. And so we'll be here to continue to hold the administration accountable. But obviously, a change in administration would be ideal for our cause and for our practice.
As I mentioned at the beginning, I mean, immigration certainly was a big issue at the beginning of the Donald Trump presidency, perhaps disappeared a little bit down the agenda, particularly since the coronavirus outbreak came. How many people and how strong an issue do you think people still feel it is, though, when they cast their ballots?
From the reports that we're seeing coming out of the polls and from the early results that we're able to see at this time, it seems like the pandemic and the pandemic's impact on our economy are taking the forefront. However, it seems that the administration is fixated on immigration because it seems to be a very strong topic with its base. So we'll see what...
We seem to have lost Pamela there. So let me just, I was going to go to Doug Herbert. So let's go to Doug Herbert and ask him how he feels.
You'll hear us,
Doug. Exactly, as ever, Doug. Immigration, I mean, it was, as I said, one of those central planks, wasn't it, at the beginning, perhaps slipped down the agenda a bit, but it's still obviously a crucial issue, particularly amongst all those black and Latino voters that we've been talking about, who, the majority of whom, of course, have been turning out for Joe Biden.
Yeah, and it's perhaps no accident that, you know, Arizona, a state like that, went for Joe Biden. Immigration perhaps should have been an even larger issue. You know, Donald Trump entered his presidential term basically with his Muslim travel ban, which we, you know, it seems like a century ago, doesn't it? You almost forget about it these days. And then he continued later on with the, you know, putting children in cages. There's no way of sugarcoating that. Literally putting children in cages, separating them from their parents. A few weeks back, you might remember there was the headline about 545 children. They're not able to find their parents. The parents were sent back. The children remain in detention centers in these holding facilities, i.e. cages. They can't locate the parents. That, you know, there's such a fast and furious news cycle surrounding this entire election, especially with the reality of COVID raging across the United States, that the immigration, which in most campaigns would have been a massive issue, that could have been one of the biggest, alongside the economy, immigration could have been the biggest plank and platform in the campaign. You almost forget about it. It almost becomes afterthought amid COVID and the economy and other issues. But an absolutely massive issue, and it's one that is not going to go away.
No, I mean, we can hear that from our guest. She's obviously very concerned about a second Trump presidency if it were to come.
And this is the problem. From an immigrant's perspective, if you do have another 4 years of Trump, and obviously there's a big if qualifier there, because as I just said a few minutes ago, we're still in a hot race here. It's far from over. If you do have another 4 years of Trump, he might feel emboldened. Because presuming he doesn't try to change the Constitution and have a third or fourth term, as he's maybe hinted at half-jokingly, but only half-jokingly in the past, and he's in for another 4 years, you can do a lot more damage in 4 years with your policies, with your deportation policies. No, he hasn't really succeeded in building the wall, despite what he said, and he never got Mexico to pay for said wall. But that said, he can also, with the department, the ICE department, the Customs Enforcement Agency, which has been very much beefed up under Donald Trump and by all reckonings has become much more aggressive in the way it enforces deportations and the holding of immigrants, that could become a lot more, a new incarnation, even scarier in a second 4 years. It would be an unchecked Donald Trump with immigration, because what he would probably claim, even if he does win, and if it is a tight race, a tight win, not a mandate, he will claim that he has now been given a mandate, essentially. He will claim that mandate. He will say the American people want these tough policies, and they like what they see, what I've done with immigration, and I'm going to continue just the same.
And do you think he could even go as far as bringing back the wall? Could we see a second wave of wall talk, if you
like? The wall has served as an extremely effective campaign theme, prop, as you may, and despite the fact, as I factually said, there's been very little actual new wall built. Most of the hundreds of miles of wall which we have seen have been really to replace existing parts of that wall along the border. Donald Trump has obviously claimed that he's built that wall, and he's gotten fierce cheers and roars from his base at rallies over it. He will continue probably pressing the matter, but he will probably also push on with other planks in his immigration platform. I can guarantee you that he will hunker down more. You had, the prospect, the Obama-era program, letting immigrant children who were brought over here actually have a path, 10 million of them, have a path to citizenship. That has been endangered under Donald Trump, and if he has another 4 more years, it won't just be endangered. You can almost assume that it will be abolished, and a lot will ride as well, and I'll just end with this, a lot will ride as well on how much control he gets ultimately over the House of Representatives. Does that retain Democratic control? And in the Senate as well. Will the Senate flip Democrat, or will it retain its Republican majority, which has been able to allow Trump to do his bidding?
Still very close in those races as well, Doug. Yeah. Thank you very much, Doug Herbert, our international affairs commentator.